Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. Welcome back to Primetime.
Thank you for having me.
So what do you think? Lessons learned, adjustments?
Well, I think there's a lot that happened on Tuesday. One thing that we know for sure is we have a great opportunity right ahead to expand on the senator's strengths. We're about to have primaries in the industrial Midwest, where Bernie Sanders has had a tremendous record and track record on trade, where we are going to expand in our strengths with younger voters, with Latinos, but also with working class voters. Bernie Sanders beats Trump, and he's very strong with voters who make less than $40,000 a year, which, by the way, is 60% of the American public. So we're really excited in reaching out to working families and championing the cause, saying, yes, we are the stronger candidate against Trump, and we can do so while advocating for a living wage, while addressing our climate crisis, by tackling our healthcare crisis in this country, and making sure that people aren't dying because they can't afford insulin in the United States of America.
You saw Biden overperform from what was expected. I mean, let's be honest, at this time last week, there was a lot of talk about whether he'd make it through Super Tuesday. Overperformed with people in the suburbs that you people need. Overperformed with what we call white working class people. We both hate the demographics, but they are what they are. Those are the labels. Why did he overperform? How do you win back, especially in a place like Michigan, where Bernie Sanders must beat Biden?
He overperformed because he had low expectations. And I think that's one thing that we have to clarify. It was kind of a last minute consolidation of some of the more moderate and conservative Democratic candidates in the cycle, which happened right before this race. And
true.
For folks who are making that decision in the 72 hours before the race, where you have these dramatic developments, that is compelling, but that is an event and it is a moment. It is not necessarily a movement,
true.
Which is what the senator has been building, not just over the past year, but over the past several years.
True again.
Also, something to notice last night, his performance among Latinos will help put critical states in play in November. Nevada,
cool.
Arizona, Colorado. These are states that we need to be competitive, and the senator and Senator Bernie Sanders is delivering key constituencies that we need to win in November.
I agree with the criticism that there were low expectations. That is actually a matter of fact. Mm-hmm. Now, it has to be a concern for the Sanders campaign that so many people who broke late broke against him. That's not new. What is new, 2016 versus 2020, is the idea of the movement. And I say it all the time, Congresswoman, that Bernie is the only one who's got a movement behind him. Now the Biden people have beaten me up for it. Whatever, that's the business. They didn't show up for you last night. The young people who you are promising to the party that you can bring in didn't come in anywhere. How do you explain that with any optimism?
Well, I think one thing that we have to see, and one huge question, is the largest prize of the night, which is California. And we are going to be having hundreds of delegates decided, which was the
yes.
largest prize yesterday, which Bernie Sanders won, not won by a little, won by a lot. We are going to see exactly what that lead looks like.
Yeah,
in
we have
the
to see.
Days.
It'll take days. You know, it's hard to know. He's certainly ahead, but you guys wanted like 60% of the delegates. You're looking at like 40, 45 right now, but let's play that out. Let's not play with the ifs.
Well, can't get too greedy sometimes.
Well, look, you know, it's a greedy business. You know what I mean? You need everything you can get because
sure.
you are at a disadvantage going into the convention, and let's talk about why. Let's be honest about it here. The use of the word establishment, okay? I think the case can be made that you lost to Democrats last night, not the establishment. There are too many different demographics that came to play on Biden's side. You can't dismiss them all as part of the problem. So you are injecting a progressivism into a party that is mostly center-left. First, let's talk about the language. Do you have to be careful about establishment? Because you make people feel like African-Americans, like all of a sudden they're part of the problem.
Well, I do think that there's a kind of a disingenuous conflating of what we mean. The fact of the matter remains that Bernie Sanders is now the only front runner in this race that does not take corporate lobbyist money. He does not take money from health insurance executives. He does not take money from fossil fuel lobbyists, and he does not have closed door fundraisers with elites. And I think that is an important distinction. Now, if you voted, if you did not vote for Senator Sanders last night, that doesn't mean you're part of the establishment. And I think think every American knows that Washington has, there's a very strong grip of special interests in Washington. Mm-hmm. Bernie Sanders has a unique integrity. He is not bought, and he has zero corporate lobbyist money financing his campaign.
You think that Biden is bought?
I think that there are real issues with where campaign money comes from, and I think it's not a secret. This is how many of even swing district members won their races in 2018 because they do not take corporate PAC money. There are some that are very progressive. There are some that are very conservative. But one of the through lines that we saw in 2018 was that if you won your race, you likely did not take corporate PAC money. It is a huge trust issue with voters, and I think that Bernie Sanders has that trust. What he says, he will do everything he can to deliver. Some things are bigger than a primary, and defeating Donald Trump is extraordinarily important. That's why I think supporting Bernie Sanders is very important. He performs better than Biden does at the polls against Trump. He performs better in the industrial Midwest. And guess what? As we learned in 2016, you can get all the votes you want against Trump. If you don't get the Electoral College, we will not get the presidency back.
That
we can
true.
Get millions more votes than Donald Trump.
Gotta get
we
in
need
the right
to win
places.
Michigan, Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, which are all the states that Bernie Sanders wins against Trump and outperforms Biden in many of these states.
Well,
this is due to trade, this is due to immigration, this is due to a lot of different issues in which the senator has exemplified a commitment to working class.